Dear Albert, can you get a song stuck in everyone's head? And welcome to another episode of Apache News. I'm Michaela Young.
And I'm Brenda Chen. Let's get this started. Today is the last day to sign up for PLAN, the pre-ACT. To reserve a seat, please bring the turnoff portion of the PLAN flyer along with $20 in cash or check to the ASB office.
Don't know what's going on in the world around us? Here's Tiffany for more on the crisis in Libya.
Hi, I'm Tiffany. So many of you have heard that Libya is experiencing some protests, similar to the ones in other Middle Eastern countries.
Libya has been tossed into turmoil as the people try to overthrow their dictator, Gaddafi. Libyans have been dying by the hundreds each day, Gaddafi using military force to attack and murder revolutionaries.
He's actually targeting his air force against his own people. And actually, if you saw the news, you could see them trying to bomb areas where the rebels seem to have maintained some kind of strong position.
Gaddafi has been in power for decades. He's holding on to power, and the world is trying to figure out what
We're in a situation right now where the Libyan rebels are pleading for support from Western nations, and if we choose not to give it to them and they take over, they might build resentment because they asked for help, they didn't get it. On the other hand, if we help them and Gaddafi maintains power, he may build resentment against them because we backed the wrong side.
As the world attempts to provide aid, Gaddafi threatens to blow up his very own oil fields, leaving the major oil-producing nation's economy in limbo.
Most of the Western nations are actually boycotting any crude oil coming out of Libya, which explains why the price spike in oil has been, and if you've noticed, $4 gasoline is becoming more typical.
Unfortunately, I think in Libya we're going to see bloodshed before it's settled.
I would say it's a coin toss right now in terms of what's going to happen in Libya, and I think the president is potentially in a no-win situation. I mean, he talks about telling the leader to go, but he's not really enforcing anything to make that happen.
There's your story on Libya. Hopefully APN will update you guys along the way. Back to you guys in the studio.
ASB is having a Dulce Mango fundraiser on all Fridays in March. Please pick up a flyer at the ASB office to show at purchase.
Do you like certain qualities such as humor or passion?
We know the speech and debaters don't.
All right, here it goes.
Yo, wizard.
Really, Grandpa?
Of course not!
Almost every single day, every time I go into an elevator, it's just in my mind listening to those people screaming.
Oh, yeah. Ah!
He's dead. Isn't he?
Over 90% of the US population is blind. It's time to face the truth.
Let's! Oy!
Want a pizza party in your fourth period class? What about a donut party? Today is the last day to donate money to the Red Cross by putting money inside buckets in your fourth period classroom. So donate now.
Do you remember when WASP was here a few months ago? Here's Angel for some good news.
Guess what, Apaches? After a year-long process and a three-day visit, the Western Association of Schools and Colleges awarded our school with a six-year accreditation term. And it's all because of our exceptional administration, staff, and of course you guys, students, the heart and soul of our school.
The WASP accreditation visit was in early October as the student group leader. We were essentially introducing them to our campus. We eventually got a six-year accreditation clear, which means they approved of our school, and that's the highest possible distinction you can get from WASP.
I'm really glad the WASP team's hard work paid off. We had to come during late starts to have meetings. We stayed after school to have meetings just to prepare for this WASP visit, and we couldn't have done it without all of the teachers and parents and students help.
What I'm really proud of is from the very beginning, we wanted to make sure that we were inclusive in all of our stakeholder groups, especially students. So I think we may have had more student representation at all levels of this process than most any schools ever did.
The students that served on those bodies in the groups and in the leadership roles should be very proud of their work. They did a great job of representing the students, and their voice was heard. And the result was we had this external body of administrators and teachers come in and say that what we're doing is right on the mark and that we're being very successful, and we have a plan now for the next 6 years. So I'm very proud of the entire school community.
And you too should be proud of what you all accomplished, because like it's been said, it is not the school that makes up the student, but ultimately the student that makes up the school. This has been Angel Ligo reporting. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Angel. Today is the last day to pick up Sadie's pictures in the ASB office at lunch or after school, so pick them up now.
Attention freshies, on March 18th, Freshman Council will be hosting a bonding night from 3 to 6 p.m. They will be showing Transformers. Bring your ID cards to the lecture hall for lots of fun, free food, and games.
Hey, Michaela, have you heard of Dramas, Guys, and Dolls?
No, I haven't.
Well, here's Ben for more.
Hey guys, what's up? Ben here. I'm standing in front of a little theater where in 2 weeks the advanced drama department will be performing Guys and Dolls. Let's check it out.
Plot in the play, well, Sky Masterson's, his kind of conflict is Sky Masterson's a big high roller, and somebody bets him to take a girl to Havana. And he takes the bet because, I mean, he's done everything, right? And he takes her to Havana, and this is where the conflict starts. He falls in love with her. And this guy can't be falling in love with a mission doll, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's not how he rolls, but he can't resist it.
Hello, my name is Stephen Volpe, and I am the theater teacher at Arcady High School and director of Guys and Dolls. I've been working on this for about 7 weeks now, and it will be performing March 29th, which is Tuesday, through Saturday, April 2nd.
And you're singing in this play, right?
Yes, I'm singing. I love to sing.
Can you give us a little taste?
Oh, no. You have to pay for that. You have to go to the play and pay for the taste of me singing.
Well, you heard it from the star himself. Craps game. You know where, you know when. It's been Ben Sager. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, guys. Want to change your life in a magical, mystical way? Take AP Art History next year. Satisfy your BPA requirement and enrich your life by examining the world's rich artistic traditions. See Mr. Johnson in room 8203 for further info.
Did you miss them?
The French kids?
Oh, yeah. But I meant Billy and Lions.
Time for sports!
Freaking delicious. What's up, guys? Muscles Glasses here. You can call me Lions Harry. Billy can't be here because he's too busy doing nothing. So all you have is me.
Oh, and this guy.
It's hot as nachos out here. I don't care. It's baseball season. Beast mode engaged. Boys baseball, they play against South Pasadena and lost 7-6. That ain't cool. But when they play against Pauly, they won 7-0. Awesome sauce.
What about Temple City?
Let me throw it off to the Kevin Richard connection for the highlights.
Hey guys,
Kevin and Richard here.
We got another epic baseball game this week.
That's right, we got the boys baseball team
versus the Temple City Rams.
And then we got... Welcome to the main event! No, that's it, let's go.
The boys start off the night right with a steal by number 3, Tyler Dominguez.
And here's Tyler again. Home sweet home, baby, home sweet home.
And Arish Trask with a beautiful strikeout. And here's Brenton saving the pitch by catching a fly ball.
And here's Brenton with a nice bunt, helping Arcadia win 4-3 over the Temple City Rams.
And here's the play of the game.
That's it for baseball this week, guys.
I'm Kevin.
And I'm Richard.
Back to you,
Lions.
Thanks, guys. Girls softball. They defeated South Pasadena, winning 7-5. They lost to CB 15-4, lost to Covina 7-6, and they lost to Monrovia 7-5. Come on, man! Is there any hope for these girls? Let me throw it out to Dustin Wong for the conclusion.
We permanently changed the softball game. Hater, while you were studying,
We're out filming. Hater tried to bunt on us. We shut it down. Ball's flying high. Not a big deal. We catch him. In softball, teamwork is key. But it looks like the Rams changed locks. Play nice, girls. Yeah, we got heavy hitters. What of it? Lady Apache's doing work. You see this? Dang, girl, what you been eating? Yo, hater, think you're supposed to catch that. Nice slide, bro, but theirs was better. Nice try, Lady Apaches, but the Rams hit harder. Next time we get serious, back to you, Lions.
Boys tennis, they defeated both Polly and Burroughs.
Freaking awesome. Are you ready for some swimming?
The Apaches play against Polly, and boy, did they serve those fools.
I like that. Boys golf.
They lost to West Ranch,
but they killed Bonita.
Are you ready for track? You want the scores? Well, you got them. They're right here, in the palm of my hand. That's it for sports. I'm Lance Harry.
And I'm Christian Aguilar.
You stay swole, guys. Beast mode.
Thanks, guys. AEF is offering driver's education during spring break. Pick up a registration form in the administration office, Mrs. Harvey's desk, or download from the AEF website. Your registration form must be received by 3 p.m. on March 31st.
Remember Victor from last week or seen some French kids around? Here's Kat to tell you more.
Bonjour, mes amis. Je m'appelle Kat. You may have seen some French kids roaming around school the past 2 weeks, and I am here to fill you in.
I like all the culture of America, music, movies. I think Los Angeles is a center of American culture.
Having a French foreign exchange student, it was just an awesome experience. I mean, the cultural exchange, it was great, and it taught me responsibility too. I mean, I lost him one day after school because I forgot to pick him up. And but it was a great experience. I mean, having him over and you get to see the way like they live and the way you live.
Everybody wants to come to America, just one time to see, and I'm sure I come back.
Six Flags was very awesome. I like the KFC, In-N-Out, McDonald's. It's an American way of life. It's really cool.
America is a very good country. There is a lot of sun and it's very different from France. I really love it. And I'm crazy about basketball, so I love it.
We play in a music band, which is called Stratian. And we play metal. If you want, you can see us on Facebook.
We miss you, Frenchies. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Kat. For all you current sophomores out there interested in taking AP US History next year, there will be a mandatory meeting Wednesday, March 16 at 3 p.m. in a new lecture hall. Be there to get your application and all your questions answered. Also, applications for any honors and AP History classes will be available in D8 beginning on Tuesday, and forms are due back by Friday, April 1st. Brenda, do you enjoy singing and dancing?
Michelle, let's take a look at this. Donate a dollar to Red Cross and you'll receive a cute pin for your support to save children from measles.
Do you have a secret? The Apache Power is bringing back the Post Secret Project. Submit and decorate a 3x5 card in a brief hope, dream, belief, or even a funny habit to these classrooms or the school's library by 3 p.m. on March 30. Selected school's appropriate secrets will be published in the April issues. Don't worry, all secrets will remain anonymous.
If you're not already aware about the budget cuts, then take a look at this.
In Arcadia High, something is lurking. In your school. Budget cuts!
That's all we have for this week's show.
There's no school on Monday.
So have a great weekend.
Bye! Bye.